This video is made under the guidance of Shri Lal Tiwari College of Engineering Computer Department. All the data used in this video are given in the description. Hi, due to this impact of lockdown, there are various economies which are getting crashed. So you might be worried about Indian economy in upcoming near future. So we came up with this video where we used verified source data and we'll try to make you explain what could be our upcoming near future scenario with Indian economy. So this video would be divided into three parts: past, present and future. In present, past and future, we'll cover 7 points: GDP, import and export, tax revenue collection, job, inflation rate, government policies and growth in digital economy. So this video would give you an overview all about what could happen in very near future and also an idea about what is happening and what has happened. So let's dive into it.
Economy of India before COVID-19. So for that, we will be first covering the point of GDP. Well, we will be seeing the statistics from the year 2017. In year 2017, the GDP of India was 6.675. In year 2018, it came down to 6.6. In year 2019, it came down to 5.5. And in the year 2020, that is in January 2020, it was estimated to be 4.7. Now let us see the next point, import and export. The India is said to be the 17th most largest export economy and 45th complex economy according to Economic Complexity Index. In 2017, India exported for about $292 billion, and during the last 5 years of the export, India has increased at an annualized rate of 1.2%. Now let us see the tax revenue and the collection. Government of India increased to 14,288.59 INR billion. In 2015 and 16, the gross tax collection was about 14.60 trillion in Indian rupees, and in US dollar it was 200 billion US dollars. Corporation tax is a single source which is the greatest source of income for the government. Now next, coming to the job. In 2019, government generated highest number of jobs from data since September 2017. Government also released EPFO, that is Employment Provident Fund Organization. Now next point, that is inflation rate. In year 2019, the inflation rate of India was about 4.54% compared to the previous years. In year 2018, it was 3.43%. Coming to our next point, that is government policies. The Ministry of Government of India have come up with various programs called schemes or yojanas from time to time. There are almost 62 yojanas brought up by the Government of India for skill development, financial inclusions. Also brought up many schemes for startup which comes under Startup India, Make in India, etc. Let us see the last point, that is growth in Digital India. Digital India is a campaign launched by the Government of India to ensure that the government policies are made available to each and every citizen electronically by improved online infrastructure and internet connectivity. Launched on 1st July 2015 by Prime Minister of India. Schemes of Digital India are Bharat Mala, Sagar Mala, Make in India, Made in India, Bharat Net, etc.
Now let's understand the impact of lockdown on Indian economy currently. If I talk about GDP rate, so for the fiscal year 2019-20, it was around 4.2%. But amid the coronavirus pandemic, it is estimated to be downgraded to 1.9%. If I talk about impact on import and export, so India's import basket saw a dip of 16% during March 1 to March 19 period, which was mainly driven by decreased imports of semi-precious stones, precious stones, gold, and a sharp dip in crude oil prices. the export for the same period came down by 8.2% to $16.3 billion. It has been also estimated that muted demand of fuel could further bring down India's import bill. During the month of Feb to April, the exports dropped by 1.5% to around $292.31 billion. India also banned exports of sanitizers and ventilators, including artificial respiratory devices, due to spike in local demand amid corona. Iron ore exports saw a rise of 80%, probably because of the increased demands of raw materials as China returns to work. If I talk about the tax revenue collection, so during the first two phases of lockdown, it was negligible for both state and central governments. During the month of March, the earning was 97.6 thousand crore, which was falling short of 1 lakh crore, which is the minimum target. Currently, at 69%, India's taxes on petrol and diesel are highest in the world. That is rupees 13 per liter on diesel and rupees 10 per liter on petrol. Also, states increased taxes on alcohol as soon as they got permission, up to 70%. If I talk about unemployment rate, so it was under 7% in the month of March, when coronavirus outbreak was yet to make a serious impact on the Indian economy. But now, it has soared to 27.11%. The current inflation rate for the year 2020 turns out to be 3.34%. Now let's understand the initiatives taken by the government amid the coronavirus pandemic in order to make life ease for the citizens of India. For filing tax returns, concession has been given up to June 30. Debit card transaction fee has been waived off for 3 months. Also, there's no minimum balance requirement for the savings bank account. Digital charges for trade transactions have been slashed. For delayed deposit of TDS, interest has been reduced to 9% from 18%. Also, Aadhaar PAN linking date, which was March 31, has been extended to June 30. Government also extended compliances under Income Tax Act, Wealth Tax Act, Benami Transaction Act, Black Money Act, Vivad Se Vishwas, up to June 30, 2020. Digital filing of GST returns for March, April and May and composition returns have been extended to June 30. Now let's understand how digitized India has become amid lockdown. 1.75 lakh people avail Invest India digital platform, which is a national investment promotion and facilitation agency under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. A report says 42% of Indians have increased use of digital payments. Also, e-commerce has taken a great boost. So in all, digitization has increased rapidly amid this coronavirus pandemic.
After having a look on the present and the past scenario, it's time for the future. The thing that needs to be known or needs to be developed before heading out of the current economical crisis situation faced by a country. Point number one, GDP. It has been estimated that in the year 2020 to 2021, India would be witnessing a slight growth of GDP rate of just 2%. What it means? It means that India in the late phase of the 2020 would be having a GDP rate of 4.4%, which would be then reduced to 2% while entering into the starting phase of the year 2021. Point number two, import and export. As you all know, India is one of the famous countries for export of spices, food items and many other things. But India is also one of the dependent countries for technological items such as mobile, toys or many other things. So what now? It's time for the India to become self-capable. India should start their own mass production under the organization of Make in India and eliminate this dependency from other countries. In Asia, India is also considered as the country with the most number of free trademark agreements, which would allow them to have strengthened their economy by supporting bilateral trades. Point number three, tax revenue. Gross tax revenue of India in the year 2020 to 2021 is estimated as 24,23,020 crore rupees, with percentage change from previous years of 12%. Centers, net tax revenue of India in the year 2020 to 2021 is estimated as 16,35,909 crore rupees, with the percentage change of minus 0.8% as compared to the previous years. Coming to the fourth point, jobs. As you all know, many people have lost their jobs or on the peak to lose it. So I'm listing some of the parameters that the people should be known or aware of. Point number one, the people should now looking for jobs anywhere, whether it is of their quality type or not. Point number two, the industries or organization should now be economically self-capable, ensuring the employees working within them. Point number three, the people should now start utilizing this lockdown duration for developing themselves. What this will do? This will make them irreplaceable in the future upcoming time or future marketplace. Coming to the next point, inflation rate. The inflation rate in India in the year 2021 is estimated as 3.62%. There is a very slight growth as compared to India's current inflation rate of the year 2020, which is 3.54%. Coming to the next point, government policies. As you all know, government is the main body. Government held up meetings and asked the expertise at what needs to be done. The state agencies have also started buying oil seeds and pulses from the farmers at the government set minimal rates. So these are some of the points which are under negotiation or been initiatives by the government. There may be many other future things or future plans the government would be planning. Now coming to the last but not the least, growth in digital India. COVID-19 has made us suffer in all other parameters such as health, financial crisis, economical crisis, job sectors, everything. But there is a one beam of light in which the COVID-19 has given a success point, which is growth in digital India. As you all know, people have now started making use of the technology, such as installing of video call apps to contacting the relatives, friends, and other things. The e-commerce websites have also started selling off essential food items. For this, the people by sitting at the home can order the essential items and making the transaction financially, data, digitally itself. The organizations have also started their digital transformation. So these are all things the future would be facing off. These are all the things that we should be aware of. And we know that, yes, we'll be coming out of this situation very soon, but some struggle will lead us to the flying colors.
This pandemic is going to be the watershed moment in world history, where India will regain its glory as we are more disciplined, frugal, community and family oriented than individualistic. This will be a major milestone for the Indian economy and acceptance of Indian values across the globe.